Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. By-wire refers to a system where the input device and the actuator are connected by electrical wiring, instead of traditional mechanical cables. Today, systems such as throttle-by-wire, shift-by-wire, brake-by-wire, and steer-by-wire are employed. In this video, we explore their structures, as well as their advantages and disadvantages. Throttle-by-wire began to spread after the 1995 facelift of the Honda NSX. Before that, the throttle valve and the accelerator pedal were connected by a mechanical cable. The operation is really quite simple. When the driver depresses the accelerator pedal, the cable is pulled, rotating the throttle linkage, which in turn opens the throttle valve mounted on the same axis. In contrast, in throttle-by-wire systems, electrical wiring connects the accelerator pedal and the throttle valve via the engine control unit instead of a mechanical cable. When the driver depresses the accelerator pedal, the degree of pedal depression is converted into an electrical signal by the accelerator position sensor and transmitted to the engine control unit. The engine control unit interprets the signal to estimate the driver's desired acceleration and calculates the optimal throttle valve opening based on factors such as engine speed, transmission gear, and vehicle speed. Based on this calculation, the engine control unit drives the throttle motor to open the throttle valve. What are the advantages of throttle-by-wire? The engine control unit can operate the throttle valve independently of the driver's intent. Imagine a small 1.5-liter naturally aspirated engine running at 2,000 revolutions per minute in fifth gear of a manual transmission, cruising at a constant speed. The driver suddenly floors the accelerator pedal in an attempt to accelerate rapidly. In the case of a mechanically cabled throttle valve, the throttle valve opens abruptly in direct response to the accelerator pedal input. The airflow velocity in the intake manifold rapidly decreases, the amount of air drawn into the engine drops, engine output does not increase, and smooth acceleration cannot be achieved. In a by-wire system, the control unit adjusts the throttle valve appropriately in response to the driver's input, providing suitable acceleration while also reducing unnecessary fuel consumption. If a driver attempts to accelerate rapidly on a slippery surface, the drive wheels will slip. With a mechanical cable system, the slip will not subside unless the driver releases the accelerator pedal. In a by-wire system, the ESC and the engine control unit coordinate to close the throttle valve and suppress wheel slip. In recent years, some vehicle models have been equipped with a mode switch that allows the driver to change engine output characteristics, such as normal or sport. This system alters engine output characteristics by changing the relationship between accelerator pedal input and throttle valve opening. However, please don't misunderstand. In naturally aspirated engines in particular, this does not mean the engine's capability increases. Only the characteristics change. At idle without accelerator pedal input, the engine speed needs to be raised for warm-up or for additional loads such as the air conditioner or electrical devices. In mechanical cable systems, this control was achieved by means of an air passage that bypassed the throttle valve and an idle control valve. In by-wire systems, the engine control unit can directly control the throttle valve, eliminating the need for a bypass passage and control valve. So, what are the disadvantages? That the driver's intent and the throttle opening are not directly proportional. Depending on the vehicle model, the driver may feel some discomfort, such as when the engine speed doesn't drop right away after releasing the accelerator pedal. The need for extra consideration of reliability may also be regarded as a disadvantage. If the system were to malfunction and the throttle valve remained open, this could directly result in an accident. Therefore, the accelerator position sensor is equipped with multiple signal outputs, and the control unit ensures reliability by constantly monitoring the consistency of those signals. This shows the output characteristics of the accelerator position sensor in an early throttle-by-wire system. At the time, due to concerns about reliability, three independent outputs were provided. Currently, dual outputs are the mainstream. Additionally, to further improve reliability, some vehicle models use non-contact sensors based on Hall effect technology. Even so, it still features dual signal outputs. Furthermore, the throttle valve is equipped with a throttle position sensor, which continuously monitors whether the control unit's commands are being correctly executed. This sensor also has two independent signal channels, ensuring reliability. Stepped automatic transmissions and CVTs have a valve body with complex oil passages and multiple hydraulic control valves. Before the introduction of shift-by-wire systems, a shift valve connected to the shift selector lever by a mechanical cable switched between the P, R, N, and D ranges. In shift-by-wire systems, the shift select lever incorporates a position switch, which is connected to the shift valve actuator via electrical wiring through the transmission control unit. The position switch detects the driver's operation of the select lever and sends a shift position signal to the control unit. Based on that signal, the control unit activates the shift valve actuator to operate the shift valve. In some types of transmissions, the shift valve is eliminated and solenoid valves are provided for each shift range, P, R, N, and D. It is not certain which model first adopted this system, but one example is the direct select in the W221 Mercedes-Benz S-Class, which debuted in 2005. The greatest advantage of a shift-by-wire system is that the position and shape of the shift switch can be designed freely. In Mercedes' direct select system, the shift switch is located on the steering column rather than on the center console. Take a look at a few more examples. However, some models continue to use shift switches in the traditional positions and shapes. In mechanical steering systems, the steering wheel and the steering rack are connected via steering shaft and gears. In electric power steering systems, the steering is assisted by an electric motor, but the steering wheel and the steering rack remain mechanically connected. In steer-by-wire systems, the steering shaft is eliminated, and the steering wheel and the tires are not mechanically connected. The driver's steering wheel input amount and steering speed are detected by the steering sensor. The steering control unit calculates the appropriate front wheel angle and its rate of operation based on the steering sensor signals and drives the steering motor. At the same time, the reaction motor generates torque in the opposite direction of the steering wheel operation, allowing the driver to feel steering feedback. Drivers sense road conditions and tire traction through the steering wheel's reaction force. But in this system, that reaction force is artificially generated. This system offers two main advantages. The first is that the wheels can be steered independently of the driver's input. For example, on the highway, the steering gear ratio can be reduced to give the driver a greater sense of stability. When parking, the front wheels are steered more to ease the driver's workload. The second advantage is that it reduces kickback from the road surface. When bumps or other irregularities in the road surface input forces to the tires, the impact is transmitted directly to the steering wheel in mechanical steering systems. By-wire systems are able to block such impacts from reaching the steering wheel. The main disadvantage is the concern over reliability. To safeguard against potential failures, the following backup systems are installed. The Nissan system features a steering shaft with an integrated clutch. During normal operation, the clutch is disengaged and the system functions as a by-wire system. Whereas in the event of a failure, the clutch engages and the system functions as a mechanical steering system. The Toyota system is equipped with a backup power supply to ensure operation in the event of a power loss. The Tesla system incorporates two steering motors, one of which functions as a backup. At present, steer-by-wire systems are adopted in only a limited number of vehicle models, and therefore cannot be regarded as a widely established technology. This serves as evidence that the benefits relative to the cost are small, and is therefore unlikely that this system will experience rapid proliferation going forward. Unlike steer-by-wire systems, brake-by-wire systems are essential in electric vehicles. In this context, electric vehicles refers to battery EVs, self-charging hybrids, and plug-in hybrids, equipped with regenerative braking. In these vehicles, a single action of depressing the brake pedal must operate both the conventional friction brakes and the regenerative brakes. Moreover, a brake failure could lead to a serious accident. For this reason, brake-by-wire systems require more robust fail-safe functions than throttle or steering-by-wire systems. There are various types of brake-by-wire systems depending on the automaker and vehicle model, but here we will explore one example. When the brakes are not applied, the hydraulic pump operates to store high-pressure brake fluid in the accumulator. When the brake pedal is depressed, the brake fluid pressure inside the master cylinder increases. When only the regenerative brake is engaged, the control unit closes valve number 3. As a result, the brake fluid pressure from the master cylinder is not transmitted to the brake calipers, and the friction brakes do not operate. To provide a natural braking feel for the driver, the stroke simulator operates to allow a certain amount of brake pedal travel. The control unit calculates the optimal braking force based on input from the brake pedal sensor, and controls the motor generator to produce the braking force. When the friction brakes are to be applied, the control unit opens valve number 1. The brake fluid pressure in the accumulator is transmitted to the brake calipers, generating braking force. When the braking force reaches the target value, valve 1 closes, and braking force of the friction brake is maintained. When the brake pedal is released, valve 2 opens, and the brake fluid pressure in the brake calipers is returned to the reservoir tank. What happens if the system fails? When the driver turns the system on, valve 3 is supplied with electricity and closes. Conversely, if a failure occurs and the control unit cannot supply electricity, valve 3 remains open. In this state, when the brake pedal is depressed, the brake fluid pressure in the master cylinder is transmitted to the brake calipers, and the friction brake operates. However, since the power assist from the hydraulic pump does not function, a great amount of force is required to operate the brake pedal. This system connects the master cylinder and brake calipers through brake fluid pressure. However, this is only an emergency backup, and during normal operation, it is a brake-by-wire system that does not rely on the brake fluid pressure from the master cylinder. Brake suppliers are developing fully electronically controlled by wire systems that do not use hydraulics. It incorporates an electric motor and a ball nut inside the brake caliper and operates based on signals from the sensor installed in the brake pedal. In the event of a failure, this system cannot rely on any physical backup such as hydraulics or linkages. It'll be interesting to see new models equipped with this system and to find out how brake suppliers ensure its reliability. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.